We want to find f of x if y equals f of x satisfies the differential equation dy dx equals 28yx cubed, and the y-intercept of the curve y equals f of x is 5. We can solve the differential equation using the method of separation of variables because the given differential equation fits this form here, which means we can write the equation in the form where we have a function of y times dy on one side and a function of x times dx on the other side. And once we have the equation in this form, we can integrate both sides of the equation and then solve for y. So starting with the given differential equation, dy dx equals 28yx cubed. Let's multiply both sides by dx. I'll write this in differential form. So we have dy equals 28yx cubed dx. And because we have the dy on the left, we want this factor of y on the left. So for the next step, we'll divide both sides by y. Let's write this as 1 divided by y dy equals 28x cubed dx. Now that we have a function of y times dy equals a function of x times dx, we'll integrate both sides of the equation and then solve for y. Notice how we're integrating with respect to y here and with respect to x here. Well, the integral of 1 over y with respect to y would be equal to natural log absolute value y. Sometimes you'll see textbooks leave off this absolute value, and we'll see why in just a moment. We'd also have plus a constant, but because we'll also have a constant on the right, we'll just put one constant on the right. So we'll have equals, the integral of 28x cubed would be 28 times x to the fourth divided by 4 plus, we'll call it c sub 1, where again c sub 1 combines the constant on the left and on the right. Let's go ahead and simplify this. We have natural log absolute value y equals 7x to the fourth plus c sub 1. Now from here we want to solve this for y. One way to do this would be to write this log equation, which is base e, as an exponential equation where we'd have e raised to the power of 7x to the fourth plus c sub 1 equals y. The other option is to exponentiate both sides of the equation, meaning e raised to the power of this quantity must equal e raised to the power of this quantity. So notice how the left side simplifies nicely to just the absolute value of y, but because on the right side we have e raised to some power, which is always positive, we can drop the absolute value and just write y equals. And now for the right side, because we have a sum here, we can write this as e to the power of 7x to the fourth times e to the power of c sub 1. But e to the power of c sub 1 is just another constant. So if we let a equal e to the power of c sub 1, we could write this as y equals a times e to the power of 7x to the fourth. So this would be the general solution to the given differential equation, but now because we're told the y-intercept of the curve is 5, this means y of 0 equals 5, or that the function contains the point 0 comma 5. So using this information, we can find the value of a by substituting 0 for x and 5 for y. So using the equation y equals a times e raised to the power of 7x to the fourth. Notice if x is 0 and y is 5, we'd have the equation 5 equals a times e raised to the power of, well, if x is 0, this exponent would be 0, e to the 0 is equal to 1, and therefore a is equal to 5. Which means the particular solution to this differential equation with a y-intercept of positive 5 would be f of x equals a, which is 5, times e raised to the power of 7x to the fourth. I hope you found this helpful.